Hello guys, in this video we'll learn how to install Microsoft SQL Server 2019, how to download the software. On the screen we have shown the link where we can download the software, either developer version or express version or evaluation version. So go to this download link and you can find out your software. So there are two versions, one is developer and one is express. In SQL Server 2019 developer, it's a fully featured and it's free to use. We can use this version either in development or test environment, but not in your production environment. And the other Express Edition, SQL Server 2019, it's also a free edition. Can be used either for development and production for your desktop, not for server edition. You can also use for your small server application as well as, which is free edition. So these are both are free. The same link, you can download these two versions. And we are going to see developer version to install on Windows 10. Once you click on the developer version, it will pop up a window to download. Click on download on the next screen. Once you click on download, we can save that file, and this SQL Server 2009 is available for Windows, Linux and Docker containers. Not only Windows, we can also install on Linux and Docker. There are certain tools and connectors available on the same link where you want to use to install for Management Studio, Data Tools, Migration Assistant, Assistant for Oracle Migrating, Azure Data Studio. And the connectors available for your ADO.NET, JDBC, ODBC, Python and Ruby as well as. So if you are using any other application like Python and Ruby, you can use these connectors, download and configure. So once you got the save, the file got saved, you can see either developer version or evaluation version, whatever the file you have saved it for. Then we'll go for installing your developer version. From the downloads, we can copy into one of the folder and save it. We can find out that downloaded version. So we have a downloaded developer edition where we can right click and initiate your installation process. You need to run as administrator, so use run as administrator option in execution. In this edition where we have basic, custom and download media, basic, the other one custom and download media. In basic, it has its own default configuration and get installed with just next installation process. It's not typical. Whereas custom, it somehow typical where we can customize our own products to be chosen while installation process, and we can have our named instance. We can have our named instance as well. It has its own wizard where we can input detailed, and it takes longer than your basic edition. But we'll go with custom edition to learn more about the detailed version to install. In download media, this is the option where you can download your setup files and you can install later. So let's choose custom installation type. The target location set where you want to download, and the default it says C:\SQL2019. You want to change that location, browse the location where you want to have. Click on install. It's downloading the install package and download it successfully. We can see the options here in the left panel, the installation, maintenance, tools, resource, advanced, and options. Under installation, we have new server standalone installation option. Or also you can add features to existing installation with this option. We can install reporting services, we can install management tools, tools as well as and data tools under installation. And under maintenance, if you click on maintenance, we can see edition upgrade and repair. Also, want to remove the node from the SQL failover cluster. Under tools, we have system configuration checker. You want to check before installation. You can launch this tool. And the features discovery report, the installed features. We have resource option, different kind of resources like online books available, tech center and developer center as well as. We have community. Under advanced, we can choose install based on configuration file if you have already defined configuration file from the existing server. Example, if you want to set up 40 servers or 50 servers and you can't go and input every time, the first server you can input whatever configuration you want to have. Once got created the configuration file, you can use the same configuration file installing the other servers choosing this option. You can click on this and you can see a window opens to find out the configuration file to choose. You can choose that configuration file and we can install that method. So it helps where we don't need to give multiple times in the input for every server, each and each server. So under installation, let's click on new server installation. You can see in the left panel, product key, license terms, global rules, Microsoft update, product updates, install setup files, install rules, feature selection, configuration rules, ready to install, and installation progress and complete. We need to follow these processes. As we are going to install developer edition, choose developer edition. Or you want to go with evaluation or express, choose it here. If you have the product key, you can enter the product key as well as the same moment. Let's choose developer edition, which is free, and go for next option. Accept the license key. Accept the license terms and agreement. You want to get updates or you want to uncheck? It's recommended. Let's check on update. So that automatic updates are being done. Click on next. So the installation setup files are in progress. The scan for product updates completed and download setup files have been skipped. Extract setup files have been skipped because already it's been downloaded and extracted. In your case, it will take some time to get download and extract. So we'll wait till it get progress. Only one warning, we can see Windows firewall. We can ignore and continue as of now, or you can turn off your firewall and you can go to next step. Now you can choose your instance features, the database engine service. You can have your full text analysis service, client tools backward compatibility, client tools SDK, client connectivity SDK. In case you want to opt for integration services and client tools connectivity, check out. We are not using any machine learning on the server, so we didn't went with checking out or replication server. The root directory for instance, you can choose either C directory or either whatever the free space available on your directory. Click on next. I'm going with the default. In this instance configuration, we can set with the default name, the default instance name with MS SQL Server. If not, you can have your own named instance name here. You can enter input your instance name. As of now, we'll go with the default instance name. Most of the companies, they prefer default, or in case if they have multiple instances running on the same server with different instance names. Click on next. Under server configuration, we can see server account, and we have account name and password. The startup type, server agent, database engine, analysis services, and integration services. The one, the account you want to start it, you can name it with different account names if you have, or the same default. You can change the startup type, either manual or automatic, based on your requirement. I'm going to set SQL Server Agent as automatic and rest of the services as automatic. Click on Next. In the database engine configuration, we can see server configuration, data directories, tempdb, maxdbop, memory, and file stream. Under this server configuration, you can log in the authentication mode. We can choose either Windows authentication mode or mixed mode. Mixed mode, we can use either SQL Server or Windows as well. Commonly, we use mixed mode only. Or if not, we can use only Windows authentication mode. But still, it's recommended to go with mixed mode and enter your password. And add your current user of your Windows. Click on Add Current. Got added now. Click on Next. Password does not match. On data directories, you can verify, want to rename, relocate in different directories, either your backup directory, either your log directory, or user database directory. Commonly, they can avail either an E drive, F drive. Under memory, you can set the recommended memory which is needed, or the default memory you want to go with. We'll go with the default. Use an error, so we'll go with the default. The server configuration for analysis server configuration, we can choose multi-dimensional and data mining mode, and add the current user as well. Next, it's ready to install now. The configuration has been done. You can see the configuration here. The list of all the configuration we have chosen. Edition developer, install product update and prerequisites already installed. PowerShell, VC++, Visual Studio Tools, features, database engine services, analysis services, full text, client tools, integrated services, client tools SDK, backward compatibility, and your instance name. The default directory, the root directory where we are going to install your binaries. Click on install. You can see even here a configuration file. So this configuration file you can use, reuse in the other servers to recreate with the same configuration, whatever the inputs you have given here, so that you don't need to input again there. Click on install. The installation is completed successfully. You can see the status of every feature succeeded. You can get the summary log file in case any errors while installation. process to diagnose. So click on this log file to diagnose your errors while installation process. So close this setup and we'll go for installing your SQL Server management tools as well as. You can click on SQL Server management tools option under installation. You'll get the download page. Under download, you can download the free SSMS. So now we'll see how to install your SQL Server Management Studio. You can download from Microsoft. We are on the same page where we can download, which is SSMS is free. You can download with the version 18.5.1, which is the latest general availability version of your SSMS. Which was released on June 9th of 2020. So this month they have released. You can click on this to download. You can see a setup file is getting downloaded. Click on save file to download to your download option or somewhere else. Once we got downloaded, we can see a file downloaded here. On this file, click on this file with right click and you can see a run as administrator option. Click to install as administrator. So restart is required in order to complete this setup. Click on restart. So we can continue with installing your Management Studio 18.5.1. Click on install. So once we restart, and start installation. So the setup is completed for your SQL Server Management Studio. All the components have been successfully installed. You can close and open your Management Studio. From your search of your Windows, we can see Microsoft SQL Server Management Studio. Click on this app. You want to run as administrator, click on run as administrator as well as. It's getting loaded. You want to log in with the service type database engine or analysis service or reporting services. So the default will go with database engine, the server type, and the server name you want to log in with. Authentication type, the default will go with the Windows authentication, or you want to go with the server SQL Server authentication, you can log in with SQL Server. Choose the one, the database engine where we have desktop number, either Windows or SQL Server authentication. Want to log in with SQL Server authentication, the default login username. You can see the list of databases. System databases, the default, master, model, MSDB and TempDB. Under database list, we have security option, the different login IDs. You can change the password as well as here. For the SAR user, you want to change the password, right click and change the password. Under properties, we can see here is the password to confirm and enter the password. You can see the status as well as the server roles. Want to change any other server role, we can add it here or we can remove. The SQL Server agent, we can find out the list of jobs if been added, or want to create any other jobs, you can add it jobs here. And we have option error logs. Under error logs, any jobs got failed, we can verify. You can click on current to find out any jobs got failed. Under management, we have a maintenance plans. You want to create any maintenance plan for any database backup job or any other database jobs, you can add it over here. So these are all the options under database engine. You can manage your database engine using SQL Server Management Studio. You can have a new query option, same as Oracle Toad. We can write your queries from here. You can write your select statement, the DML statements over here. We can save it and we can run those statements. We can execute the statement. We can get the database version using select @ version. You can run this query to get your version. Click on execute. Now we can see the result here. It shows SQL Server 2019. So done with your installation process, guys, and you can implement in your laptop. In case you have any doubts or issues, you can comment us so that we can help you out. Okay guys, thank you all.